Good morning, students. You are there? Yes, yes. How are you? Yeah, I am fine here. Yes, Amulya. Yes, we are all online. Kirtana. Okay, good. So, what's up? So, last class we were dealing with the blood groups. I think you remember. Blood groups we discussed. So I told you the various blood groups A, B, AB and O. I hope you remember it. Just a bit background I'll give you, so you will understand that. Okay. So blood groups we have. Blood group A, we is deciding based on what type of antigen they have on RBC. So antigen if you have on RBC as A, your blood group is A. Right? If you have antibodies against A person, you will have antibodies against B. Anti-B you have. So the person with A blood group can donate the blood to only A blood group and he can give the blood to AB blood group, not for O. What about the receiving type? He can receive the blood from A and O because O blood group do not contain any type of antibodies. In this plasma, it can be donated to O. O is a universal donor because he contains only antibodies, no antigens in the RBC cells. Then person having B blood group will have antigen B and antibodies against A. And he can donate the blood to B and AB and he can receive from B and O. Right? We discussed this last class, isn't it? Then coming to the O blood group, they contain no antigens. There are nil antigens. There are zero antigens. So the name is zero, means nil antigens. So they contain both the antibodies against A and antibodies against B. But while donating, they can donate the blood to all other blood groups, A, B, AB and O, because there are no antigens, only they have antibodies. They can only donate. But while receiving time, they can receive only from the O blood group. Right? So they are the universal donors. Then if you consider AB blood group, they contain both A and B antigens, but there are no antibodies in their plasma. So they can donate the blood only to AB, but they can receive blood from A, B, AB and O. So we call them as universal acceptors or universal recipients. Right? So now this much we have already discussed, isn't it? We have finished in the last class. You are writing it. Okay. Okay, fine. You know it. Very good, children. Very nice. You know all that. I'm sorry. Yeah. Can you see now? Camera you adjusted? I'm so sorry for that. I didn't adjust the camera. Camera was only there, I think. Now you can see, I think. Na? A blood group people have antigen A, antibody against B. They can donate to A and AB, but receive from A and O. B from having B antigen, antibodies against A, then donate B and AB, but receive from B and O. But O blood group, they have no antigens in the plasma, so the zero antigen blood group is O blood group. They can have antibodies, anti-A and anti-B, but donate to A, B, AB and O. We call them as universal donors. So this is one of the questions you are expecting in the examination, that who are the universal donors? The blood group O is said to be universal donor. You should write all the things. Blood group O is said to be universal donor because they contain no antigens in the RBC, but they contain both antibodies. Because of the absence of antigens, they can donate the blood to everybody. Then they can receive only from O. Coming to AB blood group, they have both the antigens A and B, but they have no antibodies in the plasma. Therefore, they can only receive from all, but not donate to all. So they are the universal acceptors or the universal recipients because of the absence of any type of antibody in their plasma. Anybody can give them blood. Okay, that's about the blood groups in humans: A, B, AB, and O. Right. Now we'll talk about something about the Rh factor. Right. I hope you are asking me the question. What is Rh factor? Just listen to this. Rh factor. This is a kind of another antigen found in the RBC. Okay, very simple thing. If a person has antigen for Rh factor, so I'm talking about the Rh factor. So Rh factor is one kind of antigen. It's called the Rh antigen. This was again discovered by scientist Karl Landsteiner. Okay. If you possess Rh antigen along with the blood group antigens, you are said to be Rh positive. This Rh name came from the rhesus monkey in which the discovery happened. Right, I already told you it was worked on the rhesus monkey. Because of that, Rh we are taking as one of the antigen. Rh antigen is nothing but it indicates the rhesus monkey. Then Rh positive is those are those people who contain Rh antigen. Only two possibilities. Not like earlier we talked about A, B, A, B and O. There are four possibilities there. Here only two. You may have, you may not have. If you don't have, there is no Rh antigen, you are Rh negative. Right? Rh positive are those who contain Rh antigen. Rh negative are those who do not contain Rh antigen. Suppose if this is a Rh positive person. Now let us talk about the blood transfusion. Whenever you want to transfuse the blood, can you donate the blood from Rh negative to Rh positive? Is this possible? Let me see your answers. Can you donate the blood from Rh negative to Rh positive? Yes. Abhigna is saying yes, ma'am. Okay. Why? Because Rh negative person has no antigen. You can donate to Rh positive person. He can accept it. But is it this way possible? Can you donate the blood from Rh positive to Rh negative? Can you donate this blood? No, ma'am. Right? Yeah, who is that? Monisha is saying no, ma'am. Anjan, no, ma'am. Okay, listen. Listen, I'll tell you one more thing I want to clear it off. Rh negative person has no antigen. Rh positive has antigen, right? If suppose Rh positive person donates to Rh negative person, his antigen should recognize a foreign antigen, but he doesn't have antigen. So without problem, he can receive the blood. Are you getting it? So both possibilities are there. Rh negative can donate the blood to Rh positive. Positive also can donate the blood to Rh negative. Mind it properly. First understand, you can donate it. But there is one issue here. Suppose you have transferred Rh positive to Rh negative. In his blood, some of the positive antigens you are adding in the first transfusion. Suppose you transfuse it for the second time, these antigens will produce the antibodies against this. This is in the second transfusion. First transfusion is fine. First transfusion it will accept. Only for the second transfusion you cannot donate because the first entered antigens will fight against the same antigens and produce antibodies. Are you getting it? Therefore, there is agglutination happening for the second transfusion. Otherwise, this way there is no problem. Negative to positive is fine. But Rh positive to negative, only first transfusion is fine. Second transfusion can't do it because first already you have put the antigens. Those will produce antibodies against it. What is that? First transfusion only is right. Yes, only first transfusion is possible, not the second transfusion. Do you get it? Because there will be agglutination. There will be blood getting clotted. Blood vessels will get clotted and they may break. Okay? Now, there is another, this is one of the problems during blood transfusion. Second transfusion problem is during pregnancy. So if the mother is Rh negative mother, female is there. If she has the Rh positive baby, Rh positive fetus in her womb, right? Imagine she is having the placenta and this is the fetus and here we have the fetus, this is the amnion, right? So normally whenever she is negative, she has all negative blood, it will be transported through the umbilical cord to the fetus. Fetus is already positive. And normally if the husband is positive, baby will be positive. Because positive factor is dominant over negative factor. Therefore, the child will be Rh positive. So whenever blood transfusion, because baby will get the nutrients only through the bloodstream, right? She will be transporting all the negative blood to the baby, okay? But as it's the first transfer from negative to positive, nothing happens. At the same time, positive antigens will pass through the fetus to the mother. Right? But as I told you, first transfusion is fine. You can get the blood from positive to negative for the first time, fine. So the first baby has no issues. It will be born normal, right? There will not be any issue in the first pregnancy of an Rh negative mother with Rh positive fetus. But suppose she carries for the second child, that time What happens, already mother will be having a lot of Rh positive antigens with her. So as soon as she carries the second baby with Rh positive child and she starts producing antibodies, these antibodies will enter and they will break down the RBC of the fetus. This is resulting in a disorder called erythroblastosis fetalis. Did you get it? So this is the fetal, the meaning is fetal RBC is broken down, due to which the fetus will not survive after 8 months of pregnancy. This is a major issue happening in the children. So what happens if the mother is Rh negative, baby is Rh positive, for the second pregnancy, the child may not survive because of the Rh incompatibility. We call it Rh incompatibility. Did you understand this? Did you understand this? Who is not here? Why you are saying not here? Write the heading Rh factor. It is another antigen. It is another antigen is another antigen along with the AB antigens, along with AB antigens, another antigen along with the Rh, along with AB antigens, it was discovered by scientist Karl Landsteiner. I written the spelling on the board, which you can check it. Karl Landsteiner. Karl Landsteiner. In a type of monkey species called rhesus monkey, RHESUS. Rhesus monkey. Next. These antigens are found along with A and B antigens. These antigens are found along with A and B antigens. And those possess the antigen are said to be Rh positive. And those possess the antigen are said to be Rh positive. Next. Those who do not contain Rh antigen are said to be Rh negative. Those who do not contain Rh antigen are said to be Rh negative. Among human population, 96% are Rh positive people. Among human population, 96% are Rh positive and only 4% are Rh negative. And only 4% are Rh negative. written. How many students have RH negative blood group? Let me see. Yeah, AB negative, huh? Sanjay. Okay, O negative. Yeah, negative only I'm asking. Why are you writing positive blood groups? Only I'm asking B negative. B Gnashati or B negative? Okay, good. Srinivas, O negative. Why I'm saying it is very rare? Because you will not get the blood at all whenever you need it. It's not something great to have negative blood group. Imagine, if you don't have blood group, when you need, then you will be in trouble. That's why it is a rare blood group, is very problematic. Then, ma'am, there are blood banks. No, ma'am. All blood banks will not contain rare abignalism. Blood banks will not contain all the blood wasting there. Okay. If you have negative blood group, you will have to first only identify who are all donors and you directly contact them. Don't worry about the blood banks. Blood banks, I have seen so many times, they will not be providing negative blood groups. Okay. Don't worry about blood banks are there and they will help you to find out who are all negative blood group of your type. Be with their contacts. Whenever you require, you should directly contact them rather than blood banks. Written? Then, okay, right now, significance of RH factor, side heading, significance of RH factor. First one, during blood transfusion. During blood transfusion, right now, blood has to be tested. Blood has to be tested for RH factor. Blood has to be tested for RH factor. For RH factor, along with AB antigens, along with AB antigens before blood transfusion. Before blood transfusion, blood has to be tested for RH antigen along with AB antigens before blood transfusion. I'm repeating. Blood has to be tested for RH factor along with AB antigens before blood transfusion. You have written? Good. Okay, fine. Good. Rh positive blood can receive Rh negative blood. Rh positive blood can receive Rh negative blood any number of times. Any number of times. But Rh negative person cannot receive Rh positive blood after first blood transfusion. After first blood transfusion from Rh positive. First blood transfusion from Rh positive. Did you finish? Good, very fast you are. Yeah, good. Next. This is due to the development of antibodies. Due to the development of antibodies. Development of antibodies against Rh antigen. Against Rh antigen after first transfusion. After first transfusion. Yes, good. You're writing so well, so fast. After first transfusion, then? Okay, second point, right? During pregnancy of Rh negative woman, with Rh positive fetus. Rh negative woman with Rh positive fetus. Yes. I repeat. You want me to repeat? Okay. Listen. During pregnancy of Rh negative woman with Rh positive fetus. I repeated. Priscilla, you are written? Okay, fine. Rh positive fetus. I repeated Sauba. Sauba Tahreem. 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 Okay, fine. Next. When Rh negative woman marries to Rh positive man, in her first pregnancy, in her first pregnancy, She carries Rh positive fetus. She carries Rh positive fetus. In the bracket, you write Rh positive factor is dominant over Rh negative. Rh positive factor is dominant over Rh negative. Rh negative. Then, next point. Yes. Done. Next point. First child is born normal. First child is born normal. But during childbirth, large amount of fetal blood enters the mother's bloodstream. Large amount of fetal blood enters the mother's bloodstream. Next, during her second pregnancy, with Rh positive fetus, The previous Rh antigens produce antibodies against the Rh factor of the second fetus, resulting in breakdown of RBCs in fetus. The disease is called erythroblastosis fetalis. Write the proper spelling. Erythroblastosis. Erythroblastosis. Erythroblastosis fetalis. Erythroblastosis fetalis. Erythroblastosis. BLASTOSIS. Erythroblastosis fetalis. I repeat, ma, what is this? Sanjaya? Sharit, listen. I said, it results in breakdown of RBCs of the fetus, resulting in a disease, erythroblastosis fetalis. I repeated the sentence. Yes, what is the question? Woman can never, it has to be given some precautions. Actually, there is one more precaution for this, I'll tell you. First, you write this, I'll tell you. So once, suppose she had a first baby with Rh positive factor, after the first child is born, mother will be given with one injection. We call that as anti-rogam, right? She will be given with one injection, its name is anti-rogam. The mother should be given with this injection within 6 hours of first childbirth. Then what happens? She will be free from the antigens, right? She will have to get free from the antigens. So these will kill it. Now after taking this injection, she can have a second baby. But if it is not happening immediately after the first childbirth, then she cannot have any successive babies, not only second, third, fourth, all of them. And imagine another thing, suppose she had a first baby abortion, then also she can't have the second. For her it is abortion, but her body, she will have already antigens. So for her, it is a first child, but she is like having second child. That's the reason why she can't even produce the first child for her if she has a first abortion. Right? Therefore, they have to first immediately when they go to the hospital, once she becomes pregnant, she will have to check her Rh factor. So in the maternity homes, they will write in her charge sheet, Rh negative mother. That should be boldly written so that they will take more care when the first child is born. Otherwise, it's so difficult. Right? Got it? Better? Write down. Write down treatment. If Rh negative mother produce Rh positive child for the first time, I repeat, when the Rh negative mother produces the Rh positive baby for the first time, she is treated with anti-rogam injection anti-rogam injection yena madam chanbasappa ma'am, then there will be no problem with the mother and father have Rh positive, Rh negative. You tell me whether father will produce a child anytime. Have you heard about that, Chanbasappa? Who will become pregnant? I understood here, if mother is Rh positive, father is Rh negative, what happens? You tell me, no? Mother will be circulating blood, so these problems happen. Father is only giving sperm. I understood your question. Both blame, Andrena? No, not both same. Only mother, if she is negative, it's a problem. Father is positive, negative, positive, no issues. Because mother is going to supply the blood to the child. That's the reason why mother will have to be positive. If she is negative, it's a problem. Otherwise, no problem at all. Did you all others understood or only Chanbasappa has got doubts? What about other children? Understood. Because mother will be supplying blood to the fetus. Father will only help in fertilization and providing sperms. So there is no issue if he is negative or positive. Okay, good. Fine. Written? ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ ಮಧ್ಯ ಅಡ್ಡ ಅಡ್ಡ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಂಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಿಂದೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ. ಪಾಠ ಮುಗಿಯೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಂದು. ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ. ಲಿಸನ್, ಫೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ನೋಡಿ ಯಶಸ್ವಿ. ಇಟ್ ಡಸೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ಫಾದರ್, ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಯಾವುದು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಮ್ಮ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಮಗು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ತಗೊಂತದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಪ್ಪನ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಪ್ಪನ್ ತಗೊಂತದೆ. ದಟ್ ವೇ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್. ಆಂಟಿ ರೋಗಾಮ್ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಇದೀವಿ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲ. ಆಂಟಿ ರೋಗಾಮ್ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ 6 hours ಆಫ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಬರ್ತ್. 6 hours ಆಫ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಬರ್ತ್ okay, anti-rogam injection before 6 hours of first child birth. Full stop. It nullifies the RH antigen in mother's bloodstream. Understood, huh? Fine then. Now listen. Actually, whether RH negative, produce RH negative or positive baby and all, it's an inheritance. That you will be learning next year, because you cannot immediately understand, because you have to learn about the genetics properly. Because if the person is RH negative, baby will be negative. Sometimes positive people have negative antigens also inside. That I can explain you only next year, because there is a huge genetics behind this. That's this much only you understand. Positive mother illa agra amma negative idre maguge andre suppose she marries. Therefore, positive person only is a problem. If she marries a negative person, there is no issue, right? Therefore, before getting married, you have to check the blood group of yours and the would-be blood group, right? If it is you are negative, think of negative blood group person only, so that you will have no issues. You will have a negative khandan. Khandani negative blood groups you will have, right? Do you understand that? So negative people have to not to bother. Nullify the RH antigens in the mother's bloodstream is right. Okay, done. Now I'll give you one method or a procedure how to check the blood groups. Blood group checking. Enga check martivi blood group anta. Suppose there is, what you require is we need one blood group checking needle sigutte. Injection needle sikru saaku. Ondo ondu yardu check madbeku nan check madbeku andre ee tip alli ಒಂದು ಕಾಟನ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಂಟಿ ಸ್ಟರ್ಲೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಏಜೆಂಟ್ ಇಂದ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡೋದು. ಟೇಕ್ ದ ನೀಡಲ್, ಪ್ರಿಕ್ ಒನ್ಸ್, ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಆನ್ 3 different ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್, ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್, ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್. ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್ ಇದ್ದು ಒಂದು ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಹಾಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್. ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಅಂತ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಎ ಅಂತ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಎ ಒಂದರಲ್ಲಿ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಬಿ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಡಿ. ಈ ತರ 3 ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಗಳು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಯು ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು? ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಆಂಟಿಬಾಡೀಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ, ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ, ಆರ್ಬಿಸಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆದಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಆಂಟಿಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಎ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಟಿಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಬಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಟಿಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಡಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಂಟಿಬಾಡೀಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆಂಟಿಜೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಆರ್ ಎಚ್ ಆಂಟಿಜೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. This is for the orange factor. Okay. If suppose you add anti-serum, ये तो हमने सेल पर इकट दूर आप एक drop, अदर मुद्दे जो अदर मेल आके इधर enter कर दे, सेंट तो दो ink pillar तरह तो हम बोलते हैं anti-serum A दिखा के, anti-serum B आ के, anti-serum D दिखा के, मोरों नो। अमेले, वो तो toothpick तरह तो हम बोलते हैं mix the both of them, mix both all of them, separate separate toothpicks, mix मार दागा, suppose this after some time it will clot, clot अंदर इंगा करते cells will get separated from the plasma in one break up agutte masru odu hogutala hange in clot agutte this is called agglutination agglutination adre yen artha anti serum nalli enalli blood clot adre yen artha yes It contains A antigen. That is, he may be blood group in question is A. Right? One way, he will clot. Agade idre matra. You have to see B also. If there is no clumping, clear cut thing, there is nothing clumped, no agglutination. Only A antigen you have. Other cause can you A blood group? Illi nine erdu possibility ide. ಒಂದು ಏಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ನೋ ಏಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಥವಾ ಏಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಏಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆರ್ ಎಚ್ ಆಂಟಿಜನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಇದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ಇದೆ ಓಕೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಇದ್ರೆ ನೀಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಲೈನ್ ಹಾಕೋಬೇಕು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಹೀಗೆ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಈಗ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾನು ಹಾಕ್ತೀನಿ ಅವಾಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋ ಅಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಂಟಿಜನ್ ಎ ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಅಂತ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಎಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ಲಾಟಿಂಗ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿ ಆಂಟಿಜನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿ ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಎಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಯು ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ನೋ ಎಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಷನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಬಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಇಟ್ Same thing. Now, if there is no agglutination, andre you don't have A antigen. If there is no agglutination, that means you don't have B also. So it is a O blood group. Then, anti-serum D. If you show agglutination, you are O positive. If there is no agglutination, you are O negative. Correct? Right. Suppose there is agglutination here, means you have A antigen. Again, you have agglutination here also. Then you have both antigens A and B. Your blood group is AB. If there is agglutination here also, you are AB positive. If there is no agglutination, you are AB negative. This is how you have to check the blood groups. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಇದು ಟೇಬಲ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಎಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಡ್ಯಾಡಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಟು ಚೆಕ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಇನಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಟು ಚೆಕ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಂಟಿಸೆರಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇವನ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೀಜರ್ ಫ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಲುಟಿನೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾವ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಟು ಚೆಕ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಏಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಏಮ್ ಟು ಚೆಕ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಶರ್ಜಿತ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಂಟಿಸಿರಮ್ I have an artha illa Sharjit. What is that you have? Why you have anti-serum with you, Sharjit? Why do you have anti-serum with you? Anybody is a doctor at home? Oh, school in the tandri. Inna eshti na ayat school in the one varsha in the iti diya. Dhaha go girit da. Sorry, okay. Good. ರೈಟ್ ಡಾ 2 ಮಂತ್ಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಆಯ್ತು ಪಾ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಡಾ ಏಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ದ ಆರ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ 3 ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ 3 ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು 3 ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೇನ್ ಬೇಕು ಮತ್ತೇನೇನ್ ಬೇಕಪ್ಪ ನಿಮಗೆ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಬರೀರಿ ತ್ರೀ ನೀಡಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಒಂದೇ ನೀಡಲ್ ಟೂತ್ ಪಿಕ್ಸ್ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಬೇಕು ಸೊ 3 ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಚೆಕಿಂಗ್ ನೀಡಲ್ blood group checking needle don't use your safety pins blood group needles bek sarpa thick irtave even an injection needles adro aitu in the bracket sterilized sterilized andre adana heat maadbeko sterilize maadbeko sterilized yago needles next one what next What's the next thing you want? Toothpicks. ಮತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಟರಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಬೇಕು? ಈಗೆಲ್ಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಲ್ಲ ಏನದು? ಕಾಟನ್ with ethanol ethyl alcohol ethanol or detol ethanol is best sterilizer ethanol ethyl alcohol or spirit ethyl alcohol or spirit now use madada hand sanitizer kuda nanu alcohol irutte adralli gottalva adike adra munde ella benkiyala idbardu Done. Next, write the adding procedure. Procedure. Okay, you write the procedure. What to do? I'll tell you. You write your own. In madam, tell them now. Clean the fingertip of the left hand. Again, right hand. Let me use my left hand. Using the sterile needle, prick the fingertip. Collect 3 drops of blood on 3 slides each. A drop of blood on 3 slides each. You write sentence formation. I hope you know well. Collect a drop of blood on 3 different slides each. ಭದ್ರ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆಡ್ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಎ ಟು ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಅ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಆಡ್ ಅ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಟು ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಬಿ ಟು ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ನೀವೇ ಬರೀರಿ ನಾನು ಹೇಳೋದು ಬೇಡ ಈಗ ನಾ ಮತ್ತೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದೇನು ಏನು ಮಿಸ್ತೀರಾ ಮೂರುದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕು ಬರೀರಿ ನೋಡೋಣ ಆಂಟಿ ಸಿರಮ್ ಬಿ ಟು ದ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ Badra, next, using 3 separate toothpicks, using separate 3 separate toothpicks, mix the blood drop with anti serum. Mix the blood drop with anti serum. Next, observe the agglutination reactions. Write this table, the full table varied. Agglutination for clotting reactions. Write this table. Written the table. Right, fully you write, no urgency. Nothing in hurry. Waiting one, no issues, no hurry. Aram se you write. I don't want you to be hurrying for anything. Thank you. I'm waiting, no hurry. If you are listening, you can write. You need not to see me also. Agglutination is clotting. Blood and plasma separates. Because blood is a colloidal solution. No, like milk, if you put the nimbu, lemon, how it will split? No, that way it splits. It's called agglutination. How milk separates? No, it is also a type of colloidal solution. Milk is a colloidal solution. When it doesn't separate, it is no agglutination. No, it doesn't separate. If milk remains as a milk, no blood remains in a blood form, it is no agglutination. It remains as it is, homogeneous. Okay, written this, write down. I'll tell you for first one, you should write for all others. Observation, write the observation. Observation. First observation, you write. If there is coagulation or agglutination, the bracket you write, blood cells separate from plasma. Okay. Next year, Kendra, repeat and then next year, yes, ma'am, and then again, ma'am. ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕಥೆ ಕೊಡಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಓಕೆ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಇಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಎ ಗ್ಲುಟಿನೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕೊಯಾಗುಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಸೆಡ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಮಾ ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಇನ್ ಆಂಟಿಸಿರಮ್ ಎ In anti-serum A, the blood possesses antigen A. Blood possesses antigen A. Agglutinates in anti-serum A. Blood possesses antigen A. Next point, in the same one, right? If there is no agglutination at anti-serum B, if there is no agglutination at anti-serum B, no agglutination at anti-serum B, blood group is confirmed to be A. Blood group is confirmed to be A. As there are no antigens of B, as there are no antigens of B, as there is no antigen B. Next, if agglutination is observed in anti-serum D, if agglutination occurs in anti-serum D, it shows the presence of Rh factor. It shows the presence of Rh factor. Aglutination happens occurs in Rh antigen, sorry, anti-serum D. Rh antigen is confirmed and blood group is Rh positive. Then, if there is no agglutination at anti-serum D, it shows the absence of Rh factor. It shows the absence of Rh antigen. Thus, it is Rh negative. Okay, same way you write for all. All the four you write. Can you write? Can you write now all of them? For all those you write now. B, till B positive, B negative, O positive, O negative. And AB positive, AB negative. Write the same way how I gave you. If it clumps or agglutinates in B, not in A, it is B blood flow. Agglutination in Rh is B positive, no agglutination, B negative. written for all. Done. Did you finish? What is red, ma'am? No, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I don't know. Okay, done then. Right, next one. Okay, last thing is about taken down the table, right? Have you finished writing table? This table you have written down? Yeah. So I'm going to erase it. And last one is about the blood clotting. How exactly our blood clots? I hope you have seen. Whenever you get wounded, you get some hard cover developing after 1 or 2 days in that, right? So that is because of the blood clot called fibrin, right? So I'm talking about the blood clotting. So whenever there is a wound, blood starts flowing out, there will be a thick cover formed which can avoid the blood flow. That is called the blood clot. It is formed by fibrin. This fibrin is formed by the fibrinogen. So fibrinogen forms the fibrin, which is nothing but the blood clot. It is, right? It is made up of thin threads like this, and all that damaged tissue on the wounded area. Imagine it wounded, it will block like this. Okay, fibrinogen get activated by something called as thrombin. Thrombin will activate fibrinogen into fibrin. This is thrombin here. This thrombin will be formed by the liver tissue by chemical called prothrombin. This prothrombin first converts to thrombin. Okay, this will first become thrombin, and thrombin will activate fibrinogen into fibrin, and fibrin will be clotting. Right, this is formed by the liver, and this fibrinogen will be stored in the damaged tissue. Will be present, damaged tissue will be present, and will convert to fibrin along with that. This is mainly produced by the blood platelets. Right, this is for the blood clot, and this whole the chain reaction is called as cascade mechanism. Cascade mechanism is one produce more, another produce again. For this, you need calcium ions and iron. So many things are required for this blood clotting. Together, only after that we get the blood clotting happening. Right? It's not a simple straight line reaction. Yes, platelets only will produce that fibrinogen. Right? That is blood clotting. During any type of wounds, that leads to bleeding, after 3 to 5 minutes, bleeding stops. As there is a mechanism to prevent. Blood loss from the body. It is called blood clotting mechanism. First point. Blood clot is formed by the network of threads. Called fibrins, in which the dead and damaged parts of the blood are trapped, Next, second point. I repeat again. The clot made up of network of threads called fibrins, in which dead and damaged parts or elements of the blood are trapped. First point. Second point. Fibrins are formed by the conversion of inactive fibrinogen into fibrin. Inactive fibrinogen into fibrin. Reaction nodkontare. Inactive fibrinogen into fibrin. With the help of thrombin. With the help of thrombin. Next, thrombin is an enzyme present in the plasma. Thrombin is an enzyme present in plasma. Present in plasma. Next. Thrombin is active substance formed from inactive prothrombin. Inactive prothrombin. Prothrombin by enzyme thrombokinase. By an enzyme thrombokinase. Thrombin is an active substance formed from inactive prothrombin in presence of enzyme thrombokinase. Next, thrombokinase is produced by the liver. Produced by the liver. This complex is formed by a series of linked enzymatic reactions. This complex is formed by a series of linked enzymatic reactions. Called cascade mechanism. Linked enzymatic reactions called cascade reaction. This complex is formed by a series of linked enzymatic reactions called cascade reactions. this involves various different factors. Various different factors namely the platelets released during injury provide important factors for blood clotting. Calcium ions also play an important role in clotting. Okay, done. You write this reaction, complete reaction once. What you have to write is reaction number one is first reaction, prothrombin into thrombin by thrombokinase. Okay, second reaction. Fibrinogen into fibrin by thrombin. So calcium ions are required for this. Write the two reactions. Aita, so it's time up then. We'll meet again Monday. Okay. Have a nice weekend. See you. Bye. Okay, this completes this story. Okay, bye then.